Water safety and testing is of the utmost importance when it comes to the health and care of hemodialysis patients. They can be exposed to 300 to 600 liters of water per week, putting them at a high risk of exposure to waterborne pathogens. Timely and thorough testing of all dialysis machines is essential for patient protection. In this video, we'll cover proper testing and monitoring procedure of dialysate or dialysis fluid for microbials and endotoxins, otherwise known as total viable microbial count, TVC, and bacterial endotoxin, LAL. Before testing, take a moment to gather all necessary supplies. You will need gloves, goggles, hand sanitizer, sterile sample tube, alcohol wipes, permanent marker, biohazard bag, small bag of ice, proper testing forms. Once you've gathered your supplies, perform hand hygiene, don goggles and gloves. Prior to first use, new machines should be tested weekly until 4 results within the acceptable AMI specified levels are achieved. All machines are tested annually on a rotating basis, with a minimum of 2 machines per month. TVC and LAL samples should be collected before and as close as possible to the sanitization and regular disinfection of the dialysis machines. With a permanent marker, label the sterile test tube with the name of the machine you'll be testing. Fill out the log sheet. Be sure to check the appropriate boxes to indicate which tests will be performed. In this case, we'll be testing the dialysate fluid for microbials and endotoxins and should check the boxes LAL and HPC. Samples will be collected from the outflow side of the dialyzer or the sample port inlet dialysate line. Machines can vary, so always follow the manufacturer's instructions for testing and use. Lift the cover and remove the outflow hose. Using the alcohol wipe, disinfect the opening of the port for 5 seconds and let it air dry. Turn on the water and let it flow for 2 minutes. Then, using the clean catch method, fill the tube with water. When the tube is full, replace the cap and turn off the flow of water. Reattach the line and turn off the machine. Place your sample in a biohazard bag and attach the corresponding form. Place the bag containing the sample on a small bag of ice. Doff gloves and perform hand hygiene. These samples should be assayed within 1 to 2 hours of collection, or immediately placed in a temperature-controlled and monitored refrigerator and assayed within 24 hours. If the test comes back with levels that exceed the maximum allowable TVC and LAL levels, the machine should immediately be pulled out of use. Collaborate with appropriate leadership and departments within your facility to determine the best course of action. The machine should be disinfected, retested, and kept out of use until sample results are back within the acceptable limits. In addition to regular testing, the dialysis machine's internal circuits should be cleaned and disinfected on a routine basis per current CMS and AMI guidelines and the manufacturer's recommendations for use. And if a dialysis machine does not have an option for heat disinfection, make sure to disinfect the inlet line to reduce biofilm.